topic we have today is triggers. Now, what are triggers? Triggers are the special kind of stored process. If you are taking notes, you can note down this line. Triggers are the special kind of stored procedures that get automatically executed whenever the event on the underlining table occurs. Okay? So can you repeat this statement? The entire concept of the trigger is in within this single statement. Can you repeat this statement? Anyone? Has? Okay, no problem. If you are taking the notes, I leave it up to you. Okay, not a problem. So I am repeating this once again, and I will write it for you if you want that. Triggers are the special kind of stored procedures that get automatically executed whenever the event on the underlining table occurs, right? So few important words I have written over here. So it is a special kind of stored procedure. Now, what is special about this? This is also a stored procedure, but what is special about the trigger? So the special about the trigger is that how do we execute a procedure?
By calling a procedure.
By writing the name of the procedure, by calling the procedure, correct. However, we never call the trigger. These are the special procedure which we never execute. They are automatically, so that is a special about it, that it gets automatically executed. They are automatically executed, but when? So whenever an event, whenever even on the underlining table occurs. So the trigger will always be acted on some, or you can say attached with some event which is associated to some table. And there could be only three events: insert, update, or delete. Insert, update, or delete. Okay, so let's try. Okay, for this I have to create few tables quickly over here. So I will create table name. Let's take product PID 5. Let's take stock. And let's take orders. and let's take quantity int. Here it is. Let me create these tables. So I have created three tables: product, I have created a stock, and I have created orders. Let me insert the record into that product table. Insert product values, product ID, product description. Let's take Dell mouse.
Rajiv, just an inquisitive question. Mm-hmm. While inserting values, is there an option to avoid typing the command again and again, or just, you know, for example, just type insert into product values and then
yes, bracket? It is. Yes, you can.
Okay. What is it that we use in between?
I will just show you. Let me insert this one. I will show you that. So I have inserted five records into the product table. Let me insert into the stock. Insert into stock values. Let's take P01, comma, let's take 100, comma, let's take 100, comma, P0003, 100, let's take P0004, 200, let's take P0005,
Right,
so let's see, select star from product and select star from stock. Product and the stock. So these are the products, and that is the respective stock we have for each of the product. Now let's try to place an order for P0001, which we have 100 in stock. Let's see what is there in the stock table. Order ID, customer ID, product ID, quantity. Insert into orders values, order ID 0001, comma, then we have customer ID, product ID, customer ID C0001, product ID P0001, and the quantity required, example 10. How much is in the stock? How much is in the stock, P0001? 100. We are ordering for?
10.
Balance?
90.
9.
Correct. Let's see. One row affected. Let's say, select star from orders. The record has been inserted. Let's see the stock also. The stock remains as at 100. So the stock is not getting affected by this. Why? So here is a requirement for the trigger. What I want, whenever the stock, whenever the order is placed, my stock should be updated. Whenever the stock is whenever the order is placed, the stock should be updated. And from the developer point of view, I can say, whenever there is an insert in the orders table, there should be an update statement should be fired in the
stock table.
In the stock table, correct. So here calls for a trigger. So this is the thing which can be done with the help of trigger. So let's create a trigger. Create trigger. Trigger name, you can give it anything, P1, P2, 3, whatever you whatever you want. So I will say TR underscore. Create trigger name on table name. So you always have to specify with which particular table you are associating the trigger. So you say on, create trigger name on which table? Orders. For what purpose? For insert. For insert as begin and end. Now here you can say what you want to do. So what I want to do update. Update stock. Set stock quantity is equal to stock quantity minus. Now tell me minus how much? Minus how much?
Order quantity.
Minus the quantity which has been ordered. Now here is a very important concept. So try to understand it very carefully. Now see, when this is a trigger, when this trigger will fire? When this trigger will fire?
There is an insert on orders.
Insert on orders.
Whenever there is an insert in the orders. Now try to visualize what I am saying. So in the orders table, a record is coming. In the orders table, a record is coming. So it is not in the table. It is on the way. And at the same point of time, the update has also fired. Okay, so if from where I will be getting the quantity which is being ordered, the quantity has not been placed in the orders table. So I have to take the quantity on the way, from the way. So here comes a new concept. So I will say select stock quantity, sorry, not stock quantity, select quantity from inserted. Now what is this inserted? What is inserted? Inserted is a temporary table which is created whenever the insert trigger will be fired, which will be created whenever the insert trigger will be fired. Okay, so this table contains the record which is being inserted. This table contains the record which is being, the single record which is being inserted is coming over here. It's this inserted table contains that. And the life of the table is just for the the particular statement get executed. As soon as the statement get executed, this table will be destroyed. So if we want to access this table individually, we will not be able to. Okay, select quantity from insert. Now, if I take this example, what is select quantity from inserted will give?
10.
Now, if you execute update stock set stock quantity is equal to stock quantity minus 10, what will happen?
90. It will become 90.
10 will be reduced from all the products. Remember, we have to specify wear condition in the update. As of now, we have not specified the wear condition. Correct?
Yes.
Yes.
So you have to specify the wear condition over here. Where, so we will say where PID is equal to what PID? What PID?
P001.
Select PID from inserted. Okay. The product ID of the product which is being inserted. Okay, let me execute this. Command completed successfully. Now let's try to insert one record into the orders table. So let us see the stock. Let's try to insert P0002. Currently in stock is 100. Let's try to place an order for 20. Order number 2, customer number, let's take 2, product number, let's take 2, and the quantity is 20. Let's execute and see what happens. I'm getting a double message, one row affected. Let's see the orders. It has been inserted and let's take the stock. See the quantity has become, the stock has become 80. Correct?
Yes.
Now, again, if we think from the user point of view, the message which we are getting could be misleading. So how can that be taken care of? Yesterday we have done something for it.
Creating a procedure in that
procedure is already in front of you.
Set no count on.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So here you see a good example of set no count on. There is an already, I haven't dropped the trigger. Drop. Create. Now let's try to place an order. Let's take third order. Order number 3, customer number 2, product number 1, and he needs 20 quantity. One row affected. I'm getting the message one row affected, not the double message. Stock updated, order added. Clear?
Yes.
So now whenever the order will be placed, the stock will be updated. So let us try to understand the trigger once again. Create trigger name on table name for insert. So two important thing is on table name for insert. which is the particular table in which the event will occur. So in this case, what we want, whenever the insert happen in the orders table. So the event will occurs on the orders table. And what will be the event for insert? What event will occur? What event will make the trigger to fire? So that will be insert statement on the orders table. As, and then we have to give a simple code, which we were giving in the procedure as well. Any doubt?
We can also have the impact on multiple tables, more than one tables.
Yes, one, of course. Yeah. Definitely.
And we are also doing an update here, right? So whether it is possible for the deletes and inserts as an action based on some events, that's also possible, right? Now we are doing update.
I didn't get your question. You can do any operation you want on any number of tables. Okay.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Now, let's take another example. Now, supposingly, let's have a look at the orders and the product once again, stock and the product. Supposingly, you are not planning to, you are now don't want to deal in HP laptops. You want to discontinue this product. Okay, you want to discontinue this product. So you are deleting the record of the product number P0005 from the product table. Now, you want, whenever you delete a product from the product table, its corresponding stock should also be deleted. The corresponding stock should also be deleted.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So let's see how can we do that. So again, we need a trigger for it. Create trigger, trigger name tr underscore L. You can give any name. Create trigger, trigger name on. Now, can you tell me the table name on which the trigger should be created?
Product.
On product, very good. For what purpose?
Delete.
Correct. So these are the two important things which you recognize. If you can recognize this thing, you can work in Trellos. Create trigger, trigger name on product for delete as begin and end. Now, what do I wanted to do? Delete. Delete from stock where PID is equal to what?
Select PID from inserted. Deleted.
Delete.
Absolutely correct. Just like in insert trigger, we get a table called inserted. Similarly, in the delete trigger, a table, temporary table, will be created with the name deleted. Okay, so you can simply say that this inserted and the deleted tables are nothing. You can just compare them as a poly bag. In case of an insert, that means if you are getting something from the market to your place, to your home, then you get the stuff in the, you get the stuff in the packet. Right?
Yes.
You get the stuff in the packet and okay, you get the stuff in the packet. And once the stuff reaches home, you take out the stuff and throw out the packet. Inserted table. Similarly, you are throwing the garbage outside the house. So you put it in the borrowed bucket and throw it outside outside the house. So that is deleted. Okay. So they are nothing but a carry bags. Is the example clear?
Yes, but this table will exist only till the transaction is there, right?
Yes, for the period that this insert or a delete is happening. As soon as the transaction completes, the trigger is a table is destroyed.
Okay.
So we executed this. Command completed successfully.
Triggers happen only on DML commands.
Yeah. Insert, update, delete. Okay, next.
So this term, Rajiv, for example, you have it says select PID from deleted, and mm-hmm. then last time you chose inserted. So, so these are basically inserted, deleted, and updated, right? Three.
I haven't talked about updated till yet.
Oh, okay. Well, I mean, like, so deleted and
inserted,
they are actions basically.
They are not actions. Inserted and deleted, these are the auto-generated temporary tables.
Okay.
Auto-generated temporary table, and the life of this table is only for the transactions. As soon as the transaction is done, the table will be destroyed.
Okay.
So that's why I have given you an example of carry back.
Okay. So typically just a second or so.
Yes. Fraction of seconds. Okay, so let's try to delete a record. I will say delete from product where PID is equal to P0005. One row affected. Let's check. The record has been deleted from here as well as from here. Correct? Is this example clear?
Yes.
Right. Now let's take one more example. Let me check the stock first. I have, let's take P003, 100 in stock. Let's place an order for this. I have the customer number, order number 4, customer number, again, I will take 2, and he is saying, asking for product number 3, and he needs 10 quantity. Yes, what should be the balance? Initially, it was 100. The customer ordered for 10. What should be the balance? Balance should be 90. Let's check. Yes, the balance is 90. Now the customer said that instead of giving me 10, you give me 20. So I said, okay, no problem. So we'll say update. Update orders set quantity is equal to 20 where order ID is equal to, what was the order ID? 4004. Update order set quantity is equal to 20 where order ID is equal to 0004. Right? Here it is. Now tell me what should be the balance. Original quantity 100, customer order 10, balance become 90. Customer said instead of 10, give me 20. What should be the balance?
We have not done the update trigger first.
Okay, good. Orders and the stop. It has been updated. It is 20, but now here it remains 90 only. It is not 80. Why? Because we have not done any updation. Our quantity, the our trigger get executed whenever there is a insert. But this time we have not inserted, we have updated a value. So this calls for a update trigger. Okay, yes. This calls for a update trigger. So let's create a update trigger. Okay. Now, before we create the update trigger, let's understand the logic. Let's understand the logic over here. The initial balance, the current balance is, or I will simply say balance is equal to 90 currently. Okay. Old quantity is equal to how much? What was the old quantity in example? 10.
Quantity, sorry, 10.
The quantity which the customer demanded was 10. Then new quantity is equal to 20. What will be the balance?
80. Balance is 80. Eight zero.
It should be 80. How?
70. Because now balance minus new quantity is 70.
Hold on. So let's see how we will create. How we'll calculate it. So new balance is equal to the original balance plus the old quantity minus the new quantity. That means old balance. Sorry, current balance is 90 plus old quantity 10 minus new quantity 20. Okay, so 90 plus 10 becomes 100 minus 20 becomes 80. Okay. Clear? Is that clear? The logic is clear.
Rajiv, I'm just thinking, this is clear. I'm just trying to practically visualize it. So let's say we are on an e-commerce, we are on Amazon, and we place an order. And if we increase the quantity from 1 to 2 or let's say from 10 to 20 for a product, that is an update. Correct? I'm just trying to imagine this scenario in real time.
Okay, let's take a very simple example. Let's take you went to a shop to buy a few chocolates. You ask the shopkeeper to give you 10 chocolates. He has, suppose, say 50 chocolates with him. You asked for 10 chocolates. He gave you the 10 chocolates. Then you said, instead of 10, give me 20 chocolates. So when he gave you 10, he left with 40 chocolates. And you ask for 20 now, so he will be left with 30 chocolates. Now we are just trying to calculate how we will be calculating, we will be reaching to that 30, the final point. Okay?
Right.
Okay, so let's create a trigger for this. If the logic is clear, we simply have to write a code for this. So create.
But the balance is if 90 and we are ordering 20, then it should be 70, right?
But original balance was 100. From 100, the customer has taken 10. Now, instead of 10, he's saying 20. So ideally, he's asking 10 more. correct?
Okay, I thought that original balance is 90.
Create trigger name. So create trigger name on. Tell me the table name.
Orders.
On. Very good. For.
Update.
Create trigger name on table name for update as begin and end. Now, let's create few variables. Declare @OQ as int. Declare @NQ as int. Set @OQ is equal to select QTY from. Now in case of insert trigger, which table got created? Which automatic table get created?
Inserted.
In case of delete?
Updated.
In case of update?
Updated.
There is no table called updated. We have only two tables, inserted and deleted. There is no updated table. What is an update? Update is basically a combination of insert and delete.
Yeah.
In update, what are we doing? We are deleting the old thing and inserting the new thing. So correct. In case of update, both the table will be created, inserted as well as the deleted.
Okay.
The deleted table will contain the details which are going out, and the inserted table will contain the details which are coming in. So set @old quantity is equal to select quantity from deleted. Set @new quantity is equal to
select
quantity from inserted. Now update stock set stock quantity is equal to stock quantity plus @old quantity minus @new quantity, where PID is equal to what PID?
Deleted.
Anyone, either you take deleted or you take inserted, in both the column PID is same. Let's execute this. Command completed successfully. And let's now try to create a scenario. Let's take the stock. And let's take an example of P0002 this time. Okay, P0002. And the current stock is 80. So let's take an order for this. Customer number 3 ordering for the product P0002 and the stock over here is he needs P0002 stock is 80. We have 80. Let's take the customer is asking for 20. Let's execute this. One row affected. Let's check the order and the stock. Order has been placed and the balance has been updated from 80. It has become 60. Now the customer says, instead of 20, give me 30. Instead of 20, give me 30. So again, we have to write a update. Update order set quantity is equal to 30, where order ID is equal to 4005. One row affected. Let's select the stock and the orders. 30, 50. Correct?
Yeah, so this is fine. So we are updating one row, but if you update multiple rows, right, so there you'll be able to create some triggers which will go and update the respective products in the product file or the stock file.
No,
that's
no,
possible.
It will not work in that scenario. In the, it yeah. will not work. Logically, it will not work in that sense.
Yeah, that's fine because you know we have that variable which could only hold the only one value, right? The quantity
yes.
value, whatever.
Yes.
So that's fine, but I'm just checking if there are any ways.
Give me a scenario what you wanted to tell me.
Yeah, simply if I want to increase the order quantity by 10 for all the customers, right? So if at all I'm doing some update there.
For all the customers.
Yeah. So all the orders.
Order, then again, you have to do it individually because it has to be a individual transactions. If you are placing an order online, and in one order, you are placing an order for 10 products. Then you are doing 10 separate transactions. Order is one, but the transaction are 10 separate transactions. For each order, for each product, there will be a separate transaction. Okay? Okay. So if this is this update trigger clear to everybody? If yes, so we will take another example over here and let me once again show it over here. So what we have done in the update trigger, we have simply taken two variable, old quantity and new quantity, and we have taken the old quantity from the deleted and new quantity from the inserted table and simply written updated statement. Update stock set stock quantity is equal to stock quantity plus at the rate old quantity minus at the rate new quantity, where PID is equal to select PID from inserted. Simple. Now, let's take one more scenario over here. And let's take the stock over here. P0002 currently in stock is 50. Suppose we got a requirement of this product. 40 products are required. Order number 6, customer number 4, ordering for P0002. He needs 40 products. The order has been placed. Order placed, stock updated. Now the balance is 10. Again, we got another order for this product. And this person needs 20. Then let's take the stock and the orders. The order has been placed and the stock has become negative. Correct? So here is a challenge you have. Okay, this is a challenge. What does negative quantity mean? Negative quantity means you are taking an order for such a product which you don't have. And how can you take order of a product when you don't have this product? Okay. So that is a negative quantity over here.
We have a difference between the event and the action. So if at all for some reason the action is not successful, the event, whatever the event, right? So that will be also successful or unsuccessful. So both are dependent or independent.
I didn't get your question, please.
Say if I'm trying to insert one record and I created one trigger to make updates in some other table, but okay, because of some constraints in the other table, the update is not successful. So it's asymmetric. Okay? And whether that will impact the original action, which was now already successfully
done. Insert is done, but update couldn't be done.
Yeah.
So you want to ask in this case whether the insert will be successful or not?
Yeah.
Insert will be successful because insert was the main event which triggers that particular action. So that main will be fulfilled in this scenario. Okay, let me take this example. I think your doubt will be clear. So we are trying to do something like that only in this particular example. Okay. Yeah. Right. So here we have seen the update has become, the stock has become negative, which should not happen. So in this case, we have to modify our insert trigger. So I will drop this insert trigger and I will recreate my trigger over here. So I'm dropping this trigger. Why I am dropping this trigger? Always remember, on a particular table for the same purpose, you should not have multiple triggers. Same purpose, multiple triggers. So I have one insert trigger. I cannot create one more insert trigger because logically it will create a problem. Syntactically you can create, but if you will take two insert trigger and a customer bought 10 quantities, so it will be deducted twice. 10 and 10 deducted twice. So the double impact you will be having on it. So I drop the trigger and I will recreate this trigger. Let's recreate this trigger and create trigger name on orders for insert as begin. Set no count on for the time being, I am removing from here. Now, what I will do, I will take few variables over here. Declare at the rate QR as int. Declare at the rate QS as int. So which is quantity required and quantity in stock. Then set at the rate quantity required is equal to select QTY from inserted. Set at the rate quantity in stock is equal to select SQTY from stock where PID is equal to select PID from inserted. Here. Select stock quantity is equal to select stock quantity from stock where PID is equal to select PID from inserted. If at the rate quantity in stock is greater than equal to at the rate quantity required, then what begin? Update stock set stock quantity is equal to stock quantity minus at the rate quantity required, where PID is equal to select PID from inserted and commit. else. Hold on. Let's execute this. First we will execute and then we will try to understand this. Command completed successfully. Now let's try to place an order. Let's see the stock and the order. So let us take currently in stock is 80. So let's place an order for P001. P001, customer number, let's take 6, product number 1, and we have 80. The person needs 50. One row affected, and there is a message which says the batch has been aborted. Look at it and then as of now ignore it and let's see what is there in the stock and the orders. So you can say the balance has been updated and the order has been placed. The order was successful. Let's place one more order. Product number 1, and this person needs 40 quantity. I'm getting a message. Batch has been aborted. The same message which I was getting earlier. Let's check the stock and the orders. So the stock balance is 30 and the new header order has not been accepted. So by this we can see that my order is getting accepted or rejected on the basis of the available quantity. Correct?
Yes.
Am I clear on this? My order is getting accepted on or rejected on the basis of available quantity. Now let's try to understand the trigger which we have created. And here you have few very good examples. So this is fine. We have declared two integer type variable to store the quantity required and the quantity in stock. Then I have taken the quantity required from the inserted table and I have also get the set quantities stock is equal to select stock quantity from stock where PID is equal to select PID from inserted. So for the product which is being inserted, I have extracted the stock quantity of that product from the stock tables. Now we are comparing whether the stock quantity is greater than equal to quantity required, yes or no. So if it is greater, that means we have a sufficient quantity, then begin. Now here is another new concept over here. It is the first time you have seen that we have used a between and end within the procedure. Before this, we have never used begin and end within the procedure. We also only use them at starting and ending to indicate the start and end of the procedure. So why we have used this begin and end over here? We have used this begin and end over here to create a block, because by default on the basis of if condition, only one statement which is there after the if will be executed. However, in this scenario, I want to execute more than one statement. Two statement needs to be executed, that is update and the commit. So that's why I have to create this begin and end over here. Begin and end, clear?
Yes.
Okay, now So if we have the sufficient quantity, then update stock set stock quantity is equal to stock quantity minus quantity required, where PID is equal to select PID from inserted. Okay. And commit. Remember in the transactions we talked about the commit, and at that point of time I told you I will be giving a real time example to you. So this is a real time example which is saying that as soon as the transaction has been done, it has been committed, that means it cannot be undone now. The stock will be immediately updated. So the example which I have given you of Amazon, when multiple people are trying to buy the same product for which we have a limited quantity. Okay. So that is begin and end and commit over here. However, if we do not have the sufficient quantity, then it will go to else. Else rollback. Rollback means undo. So what has been done till yet? So when this trigger will be fired? Whenever the insert will happen in the orders table. So the insert has already happened. It has been initiated. So that thing has to be undone. As we do not have a sufficient quantity, so we cannot accept the insert operation. So for that, we will say rollback, undo. Is that clear?
That means since the insert and the update are in the same transaction, that means the commit will be applicable to the insert as well.
Which insert is going on. This is what, see, insert is a process. Insert is an event which initiated this trigger. Now, whatever I am doing over here, it is related to the trigger. Insert is a separate thing. Because of that insert, that triggers, this particular trigger will be executed. Right? Getting this point?
Yes, but this...
So when I am saying commit here, it is committing the particular transaction. This step which has been done, the update. Update will be committed. Okay? Here we are talking about the update. The question is of update. We are dealing with the stock table in this trigger. This trigger is initiated by the orders table, but in this trigger, programmatically, we are dealing with the orders with the stock table. So, whatever the changes we are making in the stock table, that is commit. And but if we do not have a sufficient quantity, it will be undone. So, the insert statement will also be cancelled.
So the rollback will be applicable to the insert statement, na?
Obviously, yes. What action has been done? The action which has been done, that only will be undo. So action has been done is an insert. Insert will be undone.
Okay.
So this is the commit and the rollback. So which example which I have told you. So this is the actual way of using commit and rollback. In the previous session, when we were talking about the transaction, I was just giving you an idea how to use commit and rollback. But here we are seeing actually in a practical example of commit and rollback. I hope it is clear. Now, one more important point which needs is saying something.
Yeah, I was saying that why did we get the aborted error the first time when we...
I'm coming to that only. That's what I was saying. That the second point is the message. The message which has been displayed. So, in both the cases, immaterial, my transaction was successful or unsuccessful, I am getting a message, transaction aborted. The batch has been aborted. Why? Because I was getting that message because if I have a sufficient quantity, that means my condition is true. Yes? I have a sufficient quantity, my condition is true. Yes or no?
Yes.
And in that case, this part will be executed. This code will be executed when the condition is true. And
yes,
this code will not be executed. Correct?
Yes.
This particular piece of code will not be executed. That's why it is giving a message that it has been aborted. Aborted message. The batch has been aborted, which means there is some part of the code which has not been executed. And in case I do not have a sufficient quantity, that means the condition is false. In that case, this code will be executed, but this will not be executed. So there is a particular piece of code which has not been executed. That's why it is saying the batch has been aborted. And if you want to give a more proper message, you can also write. Order accept. Order rejected. Now, if you say in the else condition, again, I am executing two steps under else. So I need a block. So I will write a block over here. Let's execute. I have dropped the procedure or not? No. Let me drop and recreate it. Command completed successfully. Right, now let's try to insert a record over here. Orders stock. P0001 in stock 30. Let's place an order for 20. Order accepted. Okay. And let's take another order. 10, 8. Again, I'm ordering for 20. Order rejected. You can see the order in the stock. So P0009 order number has been accepted. Other one has rejected. Clear? Am I clear on this?
Yes.
Okay. Now, let's take one more example that this customer who needs 30 quantity, he placed an order for 20. Or shall I initiate another one? Let's take another. P0001 currently in stock is 10. So the customer number 8 order for this product, he needs 10. Order accepted. Let's select the order on the stock. Balance becomes 0. Order accepted. But after taking 10, this particular client says, okay, let's do one thing. Instead of giving me 10, give me 20. One row affected, one row affected. See. Stock and sorry, orders. You can see the order, it has become minus 10. And here the quantity has been updated. So why it has become negative? Any idea why it has become negative?
Because in update trigger, we have not written that.
We have checked for the stock quantity only while inserting the data. In case of updation, we have not checked for the stock quantity. So the same logic which we have implemented in the insert trigger, the same logic will be implemented in case of update also. Okay.
Yes.
Is that clear?
Yes.
So these are the three types of trigger which I have given you an example for. Yeah. So this is all we have to discuss about the triggers, right? So let me go to the slide once again. Right. So a trigger, let's a quick review of trigger. A trigger is a database object that is attached to a table. Trigger are also referred to as a special kind of stored procedure. The main difference between a trigger and a stored procedure is that the trigger is attached to a table and is only fired when an insert, update or delete occurs. You can specify the modification action in this, right? So this is how we have seen how to create a trigger. We have created a trigger to update the stock whenever the order is placed. Then we have created a trigger to delete the stock if the product has been deleted. Then we have created a trigger to update, to delete, right? To for the update purpose, right? To update the stock, and in this example which is in front of you, I have not used the variables. In the example which I have given you, I have used the variable. Suggestible is you use the variables. It is more easier to do. And trigger to check and update the stock when the order is placed, right? Any questions? Any more questions from triggers? Nothing. So with this, okay, with this we come to the end of the module of SQL. So this is all we have to cover in SQL. And one thing, okay, regarding this is like you showed me the inventory management product, and I told you at the beginning of the session that if you will do all the assignments properly, by the end of the module 85% of your project will be ready of inventory management. So in that 85, so as of now you have seen that your order ID is generating automatically. Now you have to implement these trigger, insert, update and trigger, delete triggers onto your structure. Once you insert that, so automation will also be there. Then what, so 85% of the project is ready. What is the remaining 15%? So the remaining 15% is the reporting task. Now just assume that you have created this for some of your client. Let's take, I am your client. You have created this for me. Now, what else reports I want? All the reporting will be done with the help of procedure, right? So I want a daily report, which should give me the details of the transaction done during the day. So I should just write the word daily report and I should get the details of all the transaction which has been done during the day. Clear? Second, I should get a customer ledger. where I will write the customer and I will give the customer ID like C000001, and I should get the all the transaction done by that particular customer since inception. So that becomes a customer ledger. Then third, we need the product report. Product report where you will give specify the product and give the product ID. It will give you the the user should get the list of all the transaction done for that particular product, on which date, which quantity has, how much quantity has been sold to which person, and so on. Okay, then we have a supplier report which will give you the details of all the products supplied by a particular supplier as you have specified. Fifth, you should have a report on the basis of the time duration, in which you will give two dates, date one and date two. It will give you the list of all the transactions done between those two dates. Okay, then so these are the various type of reports which needs to be generated in your project, right? So please try to do this thing, and once you do this, now what I'm telling now is not necessary, but if you can implement it, it will be wonderful. And for which I have to open the inventories, the structure which I have shared with you. Now, if you will notice in the stock table, we have also taken ROL and MOQ. In the table which you have created, you have also taken reorder level and MOQ. Yes or no? Have you taken these two?
Yes.
Now, if you want, you can do one more thing. As you are selling a product, obviously you are procuring it from your respective supplier. You are also getting that product from the supplier. Okay. So there must be a purchase table. There will be a purchase table in which you have a product ID, supplier ID, purchase date and purchase quantity. Purchase is when you are purchasing it from the supplier, when you are buying the stock, that becomes the purchase. So what I want, whenever a order is placed, listen carefully, whenever the order is placed, every time the stock should be checked, and if the stock quantity is below or equal to ROL, a new order should be placed. My purchase request should be made in the purchase table, and the date quantity should be equal to the minimum order quantity. So this is all, as somebody was asking, that multiple actions can be done in the trigger or not. So this is an example of that only. Is that clear? You got the scenario? Hello.
Yes.
What is the scenario? Explain.
The scenario is basically every time there is an order.
Order goes below some threshold, so we have to raise some purchase orders, or we have to enter into the purchase order table.
As soon as the it goes below.
Below the ROL,
ROL, MOQ should be purchased.
So MOQ should be purchased. Yes.
Okay. Right now, any questions from your side? Okay, then, right, so this is what has to be done, and just
so once the MOQ, we create a purchase request for MOQ, So mm-hmm. after that, the order stock would also be need to be updated, or
stock should also be updated. Yes, it could be updated, right? That can also be done, but I am keeping it to a one level only. That the purchase has been made. You have placed the order. Order has been placed.
Okay.
Okay. So it is just an indication that we are placing the order. Once the order will be received, then the entry has to be done.
Yes, sir. Okay. Got it.